My name is Jacob Andrewartha. I'm a childcare worker. I've been a socialist since 2013. Yeah, I guess you could say I'm just an ordinary working class person. The reason why I'm running for Moreland Council is that I think all the problems of capitalism are not going to go away if I just pretend they don't exist. I have to be part of the process of standing up against any sort of injustice or oppression.
This is a conference that's bringing together, you know, some of the worst kind of corporations, you know, who are getting away with trampling on the rights of Indigenous people's land, exploiting workers and polluting the environment.
The great work that Sue Bolton has done as a socialist councillor.
Stand in solidarity with working class communities.
I believe there's space for even more of a socialist voice on council, a socialist voice that would champion the campaigns of the oppressed. If we don't raise the alarm for socialist politics, there'll be more right-wing politics that takes hold of people, and we need to actually put forward positive politics. A lot of local councils have essentially just rubber stamped what some big property developer wants and generally not really have that much democratic space or accountability. One of the overarching visions of this team is that residents should have a real say over matters of local government.
At Moreland Station.
What Community Need Not Developer Greed encompasses is this idea that we should help residents fight for their rights. All the candidates would have regular residence meetings where we report back on the politics of what's happening at the local council. We would report on how it actually impacts on people. One of the things that first got me involved was the refugee rights campaign. I helped organise a local climate rally. I've also been part of a campaign to stop the sell-offs of public housing. Housing should be a human right. The fact that there are people sleeping on the streets in a rich country like Australia, I think, is unacceptable. Government policy often prioritises those of property developers and investors over that of ordinary people.
10,000, 20,000 people on the waiting list. We desperately need more public housing.
If you want a local councillor who will stand up for all the important social justice issues, to vote for a councillor who will consult with you, to vote for a councillor who will take your interests above that of property developers, of that of business, we prioritise the interests of ordinary people. The reason why I am a socialist is the fact that I don't think that the level of inequality in this world can go on. There needs to be a system that serves the needs of everybody. Even when times are tough, we actually have to continuously raise the profile of left-wing politics and socialist politics. We need to be able to unite all the struggles against oppression and fight for a better world.